Secretary, during your confirmation hearing, you mentioned Teddy Roosevelt 9 times. Oregonians have a strong appreciation for Teddy Roosevelt as a conservationist and as a president. With his signature, he created the Crater Lake National Park, and it is the deepest lake in the United States, known for its beautiful blue. Teddy Roosevelt understood that when you sell off or exploit your public lands, you don't get them back. Mr. Secretary, that's something you don't seem to understand at all. First, you pushed the largest reduction of conserved, treasured public lands in American history. 2 million acres sacrificed for private exploitation. Second, you proposed opening America's precious coasts to offshore oil drilling, only to walk it back in one state where it seemed there was a potential Republican Senate candidate who opposed it. I can tell you in our state, Oregonians don't want to look out over Haystack Rock and see oil derricks. Third, during the most expensive wildfire season in recorded history, you played a shell game with a wildfire account at Interior to pay for an unrelated helicopter ride. And this is another matter that the Inspector General is looking at. So my first question, Mr. Secretary, is, would Teddy Roosevelt be sitting where you are today advocating the virtual elimination of the Land and Water Conservation Fund?
Mr. Senator, I challenge you to give me one square inch.
I'd like a response to the question, Mr. Secretary. Time is short.
It is short, and I challenge you to give me one square inch of land that's been removed from federal protection. One square inch. In the case of Bears Ears, as you stated, Bears Ears, after I restored 400,000 acres of wilderness, after I restored almost an entire national forest, the boundary of the revised Bears Ears is still larger than Zion and Bryce Canyon combined. What I did do is increase public access and traditional rights. Under the Trump administration, the Interior, we've actually increased wilderness last year, specifically in New Mexico. And I worked with a delegation in Utah because Utah, where Bears Ears and Staircase is, the entire congressional delegation, including your colleagues and the governor, wanted it rescinded. I didn't rescind it.
Mr. Secretary, you've used up now almost half my time. Could you give me a reason, an explanation for whether Teddy Roosevelt, sitting where you are, would advocate a budget that virtually eliminates the Land and Water Conservation Fund?
I believe the Land and Water Conservation makes $122 million available. It does not add more property into the federal estate. But our budget also has the largest investment in the history of this country on three critical areas. One is maintenance backlog of our park system. Two, maintenance backlog of our wildlife refuge system, which Teddy Roosevelt initiated. And thirdly, making sure that we meet the treaty obligations of 48,000 American Native kids. That's the largest investment in the history of this country. So I believe Teddy Roosevelt will be proud of the focus on preserving, protecting, and maintaining our treasures.
What I asked you, though, because it is in your budget, is whether he would support something that is so fundamental, for example, to what you said in your prepared statement, which is increasing access to public lands. And I'm quite certain that Teddy Roosevelt would not be here defending the virtual elimination of the Land and Water Conservation Fund. And I want to close on a personal note. Mr. Secretary, you and I talked a lot before your confirmation. And I felt in an attempt to build a bridge to work with you, particularly in a state where the federal government owns most of the land, I would support your nomination. And I did. I voted for your nomination. And I will tell you right now, as of today, it is one of the biggest regrets of my time in public service. Thank you, Madam Chair.